Welcome to Road to WrestleMania, WWF WrestleMania 2000. And this is a freaking awesome game, just like Revenge. Better than Revenge, but made by the same company, because Acclaim was doing WWF games before THQ and IKEA. Then the license ran out, then IKEA and THQ went ahead and started doing WWF games starting in 99. And so here we are. That's why this game looks real similar to Revenge. All right, so here we go. I think the intro and Revenge is better, the music as well, but again, not knocking this game at all. Because this game is better than Revenge, create a wrestler mode and all that good stuff. Man, this game is freaking epic. Me and my friends, including Venom22, had a lot of fun with this game. Yeah, I mean, so many different characters, so much to do in this game, especially the create a wrestler. Awesome stuff. And this game, unlike Revenge, has the wrestlers come out to their custom-made wrestling entrance theme songs. So that's pretty cool. That was very innovative for its time. Yes, the Brood. I remember that storyline where they kidnapped Stephanie and you're going to sacrifice her to the Undertaker. That was stupid. Of course, that was the part of the storyline. It's me, Austin! It was me all along! The whole higher power storyline. And I called it, too. I knew it was Vince McMahon. And my friend in high school was like, "Nah, are you sure?" But yeah, it's Vince McMahon. I'm telling you it is. Sure enough, we found out it was Vince McMahon as a higher power. Then that was when Stone Cold became the CEO. That was freaking funny. DTA, don't trust anybody. Austin will walk through hellfire and brimstone to get that championship belt. Whoa, Austin just appeared out of nowhere. All right, so there you go, WrestleMania 2000. So that's it. This game is cool. No, all right, here we go. I'm going to go ahead and just get to it with the Royal Rumble. The first four entrances are coming out. The first one, Bradshaw. Yeah, I got his autograph back in 2003 when I was working at a local restaurant here. He came in and I just talked to him for a little bit. He was nice enough to give me his autograph, so that was pretty cool. That's before he was a, this is after, yeah, because this is 99. So in 2003, he was just Bradshaw when him and Farouk split up. So this is before he was, I got his autograph before he was JBL. All right, now the Godfather, who would be inducted into the Hall of Fame in just a few days. I remember he was also Papa Shango, putting curses on people, making tar drip out of people's foreheads, and the Ultimate Warrior throwing up. That was so goofy. When I was a kid, though, it scared me because, you know, when I was a kid, I thought wrestling was real, and I thought Papa Shango was really putting curses on people. All right. Third entrant. Jeff Jarrett. Don't piss him off. He's doing his intro as if Deborah's with him. He's not with him right now. By the time this game came out, Jeff Jarrett was already in WCW. So yeah, Robert's contract ran out in October 99 after he lost the Intercontinental title to Chyna. Jeff Jarrett, the next night, appeared on Nitro. So it was kind of funny seeing Jeff Jarrett in this game. I kind of liked Jeff Jarrett, though. He started having more of an attitude, and I thought it was pretty cool. Then became the chosen one in WCW. Oh, Mark Henry, jeez. Mae Young's ex-boyfriend. Mae Young's in this game, by the way, I think is a hidden character. What was that, a glitch in the ROM? Oh, I don't remember him having the intro like this. But yeah, anyway, the sexual chocolate Mark Henry storyline was so stupid. But looking back, though, at the same time, in hindsight, it was kind of funny. Except when Mark Henry became a proud father of a hand, which I did not understand. But anyway, here we go. The Royal. It is now time for the Royal Rumble match. Yeah, I mean, this game, very fun. I had it reserved at Toys R Us. And I remember it got delayed a few days. There was problems with shipping. And I saw Tess playing on SmackDown. And I was like, well, Toys R Us, what are you talking about? I saw Tess play on TV. So, but anyway. Oh, Spinebuster. Arn Anderson wants to move back Jeff Jarrett. All right, wait a minute. I'm not the Godfather. Come on. Oh, here we go. Stone Cold Steve Austin, the winner of the 97, 98, and 2001 Royal Rumble. Will he win a fourth one here and make history? He's already made history. No one's won more Royal Rumble matches than Stone Cold. All right, yeah. So Stone Cold Steve Austin was another wrestler that got an autograph from. He came here at the Heart of Texas Coliseum back in Waco, Texas in November 2000. There was a WWF Monster Truck show going on Friday night. It was Steve Austin making an appearance. Saturday night was Billy Gunn. I didn't care to get Billy Gunn's autograph, but Friday night it was Austin and Rock's Monster Truck. Now, The Rock was not there, but Austin was. And before I showed up, I called at the arena. I said, should I bring something for Austin to sign, or are you guys going to bring us a picture for him to sign? Oh, we don't know, sir. It might be safe to bring something. So I brought my Stone Cold Steve Austin poster. All right. So when I get there, though, then they give us something for him to sign. I'm like, oh, well, no big deal. I'll get to have two autographs. So, but by the time I got there, the security guard sitting next to him said, oh, wait, one autograph per person, sir. But Austin went ahead and still signed it for me. So he still gave me two autographs, and the security guard was kind of like, oh, all right, whatever, fine. Road dog, look like Road Dog. And so that was very cool of Austin to do that. And I said thank you, and I walked away because it's a long line. They want to keep the line moving. That's why you're not really supposed to have more than, you know, one autograph per person. But I called ahead of time, and they didn't know what to do. So just to be safe, I brought something. I didn't want to be an idiot and not bring nothing and then look stupid for not bringing anything from the sign. All right, so. Oh, Bradshaw knocked Austin on his ass there. Oh, someone just got eliminated. Road Dog, Jeff Jarrett. Got Road Dog out of here. He's not moving. We might need to get some EMTs out here. We need a stretcher for Road Dog here. Looks serious. Oh, he's rolling out. Roll Dog a bone. Road Dog needs to roll on out of here because he's out. Cal Venus, jeez. Ravishing Rick Rude ripoff. Oh, that ruined his career. Wait a minute. Oh, Jeff Jarrett refuses to quit. Oh, Bradshaw is out of there. Christian now. This is when he was with the Brood. This pre-Captain Charisma. Oh, that's going to ruin his career too. Again with a double-team pile driver. These guys don't like Val Venus do that. Again, man, that's going to end his wrestling career, too. Jeez. They're trying to end both of his careers. Austin stomps on Jeff Jarrett. Oh, man. Christian told a story of the birth of what? Stone Cold was traveling. I think he got bored. He gave Christian a call. And he said something like, yeah, I'm traveling down this road right now. What? I'm about to go get something to eat. What? I'll see you later. What? So that's where it actually started. And then Stone Cold started using it on TV sometime shortly after that. And at first, I thought the whole what thing was stupid. But then it grew on me, and I have a what t-shirt hanging in my closet to this day. I actually had it years ago, and I sold it. Then I rebought it from someone else years later, so that's pretty cool. All right, he is out of there. Next, Hardcore Holly. Is he tough enough to win the Royal Rumble? Oh, low blow on Austin. That just made him mad. Jeff Jarrett still hanging in there. Oh, man, he might be the chosen one to win this match. Yeah, I was happy for Jeff Jarrett when he went to WCW and won the world title. I remember when he would just hit people with guitars all the time. He hit Mae Young with the guitar. I think the Fabulous Moolah put Mae Young in the figure four. To my, come here, you old bag, and put her in a figure four. I was so freaking hilarious. Jeff Jarrett, you know, I joke around with those sexist jokes about women need to get in the kitchen or women are slow or whatever, but slow getting out of the restroom or and all that stuff. But Jeff Jarrett, he was the one that was really saying some stuff like, he was having a feud with Chyna talking about, well, you know, women, Chyna needs to be in the kitchen. And, you know, she needs to be barefoot and pregnant, not be competing for the Intercontinental title. And I guess that's what Jeff Jarrett gets of being sexist because he's eliminated. Give him credit, though. He was one of the first four in there, and he stayed a good while. All right. Oh, speaking of, here comes Chyna. One of the two women to ever enter the Royal Rumble. To the best of my knowledge. The other one being Karma. Viscera now coming out. And Chyna, also the first and only ever woman to win the Intercontinental title. From Jeff Jarrett. This one went to WCW. Viscera. I remember when he was called the world's largest love machine, Viscera. Then he became Big Daddy V. Sadly, he passed away as well. I think 2014 he passed away. I remember he was Men on a Mission, him and Oscar. Men on a Mission. Then he became King Mabel in 95, 95 King of the Ring, defeating Savio Vega, I think it was in the finals. Savio Vega, that's the name I haven't heard in a while. Chyna, the Irish Whip on Viscera. Austin eliminated Chyna in the 99 Royal Rumble. Whoa, that does not look right. What are you doing? All right. Oh, wow. Lucky for Chyna, she blocked that with a knee. Trying to go for the low blow there. Missed. Oh, but Austin did not. Hello, Austin. Hello. And I remember Pat Patterson and Gerald Brisco having that hilarious handicap match with Chyna. And Pat Patterson gave Chyna a low blow when Chyna just stood there and shrugged her shoulders like, really, Pat? And Michael Cole goes, hello, Pat. Hello. Kicks out. What? Val Venus eliminates Steve Austin. How pathetic is that? Oh, here comes Michael P.S. Hayes, who will also be inducted into the Hall of Fame here in a few days. Gave him raw music. I guess I couldn't give him Bass Street USA. Wait a minute. What? Oh, botch. Oh, two counts. Chyna pulling Michael Hayes there. Oh, and Val Venus pulled Michael Hayes by eliminating him. Val Venus eliminating some good people here. Oh, Kane. Let's see if he eliminate Kane. Oh, Chyna is out of there. Oh, right when Chyna gets eliminated, X-Pac comes in. All right. What? X-Pac can't get Viscera in a back body drop like that. Oh, and a low blow. Man, X-Pac pony Viscera here. Oh, now Val Venus does a back body drop on X-Pac. I hate when people call him X-Pac. It's X-Pac, not Pac, not P-A-C-K. Come on. Wow. Damn. Oh, wow. Man, Viscera got pwned right there. Oh, X-Pac, what are you doing? Oh, wait a minute. Yes, get rid of him, Kane. Thank you. Uh-oh. Can these guys pass the test? Rest in peace, Andrew Martin. Remember his classic match with Shane McMahon, the street fight, SummerSlam 99. I still can't believe Shane McMahon's going to face the Undertaker this year at WrestleMania. Maybe the Mean Street Posse would come out and help him out. It's like he'd try to help out test it. I mean, try to help out Shane at SummerSlam 99 against Test for the love of Stephanie. Well, Stephanie ended up dumping Test and screwing him over. So he pretty much fought for her for nothing. All right. Well, Test is already out there. But he failed the test. Thanks for coming, Test. D'Lo Brown. No, he's not eliminated. He's just now coming in here. Who else is coming in? Oh, Al Snow. ECW alumni. One of the few tough enough trainers I ever liked. Dean Malenko stealing, I mean, not Dean Malenko. D'Lo Brown stealing Dean Malenko's Texas Cloverleaf. Dean Malenko is in this game. He was also in Revenge. Then he's now in this game as well because him, Saturn, Benoit, and Eddie Guerrero all walked down WCW and came here to WWE because WCW was terrible. Wait, I'm sorry, I made a mistake. They're not in this game. They are in No Mercy. I stand corrected. I corrected myself. Ronnie, you idiot. Know your wrestling facts before you mention it in the video. Because I got to think in there, because this game came out November 99. The Radicals didn't debut until freaking January 2000. So how can that happen? And it got me to thinking, hello. So I'm sorry. The Radicals are not in this game. They are in No Mercy. All right. So D'Lo Brown, that's probably why he's using Texas Cloverleaf. Because he knows Dean Malenko's not in this game. Because if he was, he would have came out and taken the school. Using it again. Yeah, you better get used to it. Because in the next game, buddy, you won't be able to do that and get away with it. All right. Oh, man. Al Snow just took out Viscera and Kane. No, two count.
What?
Post in the comments below, what were some of the characters you created in this game? Be very interested to hear. Of course, I created Ronnie Green. What's Dito Brown doing? Oh, wow. That was a good attempt, but fail. Kane now trying to pin Al Snow. Oh, British Bulldog suplex coming up. Oh, missed the guillotine leg drop. Oh, man, Kane inadvertently saved D'Lo Brown from elimination there. I remember Mark Henry told Viscera, "Want to hoist your big butt up and not body slam you? All the king's horses and all the king's men won't be able to put your Humpty Dumpty ass back together again." Oh, nice spot kick by Al Snow. His finish move is called the Snowplow. Oh, man. Got some hard-hitting action here. Oh, double-teaming Kane. Yeah, they better eliminate him. Wait a minute. Nah, come on. Dang it. Kane's one of my favorites. All right, that's all right. Oh, I think you see the snowplow on Viscera. Scott Taylor. Look at him. This is pre too cool. He is not sky too high right here. It's just Scott Taylor. Oh, Al Snow is out. Wait, Hulk Hogan. What? Oh, Pat Patterson. All right, so, yeah, Pat Patterson here in his business suit getting ready to wrestle. What the heck? Pat Patterson, Jared Brisco, they were funny together. I really love those guys. Oh. Hello, Pat. Hello. It'd be hilarious if Pat Patterson gave Chyna a low blow again. Except this time it will work. It would work in this game. Wait a minute. Another inside cradle. D'Lo giving the lowdown to Pat Patterson. Two count, says referee John Cena, because I can't see him anywhere. Oh, D'Lo Brown is out. Uh-oh. Triple H now the game. Would he get revenge for Chyna? Scott Taylor with the reversal. Nope. Oh, Pat Patterson, a tough old man, the first Intercontinental Champion, won it in Brazil in 1979. Scott Tedder is out. Who's next? Oh, it's time to get in the zone. Not auto zone. That face. Calm down, Kenny. Remember Shamrock? The last time Shamrock was in WWE was like late 99. He's having a feud with Chris Jericho, who had just arrived in the WWE. Oh, man. He puts Fisher to sleep. Yeah, Shamrock ain't playing around. All right, wait a minute. Oh, Farouk.
Hold on, but let me tell you what the bottom line is, and I'm going to kick your hunky ass. Damn.
Tried to do a leapfrog there and failed. Wait a minute here. No, Pat Patterson kicks out. He didn't retire yet. Oh, wait a minute. Pat Patterson's out. Good effort by Pat Patterson. Oh, here comes Edge. I remember ECW One Night Stand 2005. Paul Heyman goes, oh, hide your wives. It's Edge. Oh. Man, these Battle Royals are so fun. More fun to play, but it's also fun to watch on the highest difficulty level just to see what the heck's going to happen. Thanks for coming, Edge. He was on the edge, all right, on the edge of that ring apron and got knocked off. Ah, jeez, Chaz. Man. Well, it's better than Harry Beaver cleavage. And for those of you who don't know, Chaz is former Headbanger Mosh of the Headbangers. He was Headbanger first, and then it became Harry Beaver cleavage, where supposedly some guy that was sleeping with his mother, or ambiguously sleeping with his mother. I don't know. It's creepy and stupid. But they did a worked shoot where Harry Beaver Cleavage was being interviewed by his mommy. And then all of a sudden he broke character saying, I can't do this. This is ridiculous. I can't do this anymore. And someone was going, we're live. What are you doing? We're live. He goes, I can't do this anymore. And then like a week or so later, he came out as a new character called Chaz, saying, yeah, you know, they want to give me this stupid gimmick. Honestly, I'm just a kid from Jersey. I'm just here to have fun. This is not my mommy. This is my girlfriend. I don't want to do this stupid gimmick anymore. I just want to be myself. So I don't know if WWE was going to actually do that. And then they thought, no, we can't do this. This is too creepy and sick. Or that was the plan all along, for him to break character and then be this Chaz kid, which is he sucks. He does have a few good moves, though, in this game. He has, like, a reverse Death Valley driver, but, man, the character was just so lame and stupid. Then they had a storyline where supposedly he beat up his girlfriend, and then everybody hated him. Everybody was beating him up, but then turns out it was all a ploy. She lied about it. That's when Headbanger Thrasher helped him out by exposing her as a liar, that he was innocent. He did not beat her up, and so they got back together. Not him and his girlfriend, but Mosh and Thrasher got back together as the Headbangers tag team again. So at least that was a good thing. It came out of that whole Chaz storyline was bring back the Headbangers. They probably thought, this character sucks. He is better as Mosh. Let's bring him back as Mosh. And so, yeah. Chaz. Chaz gets eliminated real quick. Oh, someone almost got eliminated over there. Too busy ranting about Chaz and when we didn't know what the heck was going on. All right. Come on, Triple H, get him. You can't take Chaz. Come on, man. Wait a minute here. Oh, Farouk with the Dominator. Oh, Shamrock is out. He's zoned out. Come on, y'all gang up on Chaz. Get him out of there. Uh-oh. Who's next from the corporate ministry? Midian. Formerly known as Phineas Godwin. Real name Dennis Knight. Jeez, I'm not going to even get started on Naked Midian. Let's just not even talk about that subject. I'd rather see Chaz. All right. Midian was the eye of the ministry. Got kidnapped by the Acolytes. Got beaten up a lot. And then got converted to become this guy Midian. Become a servant to the Undertaker or something like that. And he would always come out with this eyeball in a jar because he was the eye of the ministry. I guess he's keeping a close eye out on his opponents. Oh, he's keeping an eye out on Farouk right now. Boom, Farouk is out, his ministry partner. Oh, this time it's Hulk Hogan. Nope, Gerald Brisco. Yes, sir, Mr. McMahon. I'll do my best to win this Royal Rumble match, Mr. McMahon. Again, him and Pat Patterson were funny together. And for those of you who have not seen it, I might put it in the link in the description box if I remember. The handicap match. Or if you have the network, go look on it on the WWE Network. And you get a free month for new subscribers this month. It was the January 18th, 1999 episode of Raw. It was the handicap match. Chyna against Pat Patterson and Gerald Brisco. Well, Midian's already out, and the Undertaker's not going to be happy about that. Oh, wait a minute. What the heck? How you guys, how's the Undertaker going to get double-teamed by Chaz and Gerald Brisco, for crying out loud? How pathetic is that? Why is Chaz still in here? How is Midian out already, but not Chaz? Jeez, man. Come on. Everybody gang up on Chaz. There's a $100,000 bounty on his head. Whoever wins gets a $100,000 bounty. Shades of the 99 Royal Rumble where Austin had that bounty on his head. McMahon was on commentary. Come on, guys, $100,000. Just eliminate Austin. Wait a minute here. Dang it. That would have been funny if Brisco eliminated Chaz. There was another wrestler in the Dallas, Texas territory named Chaz. Teen Heartthrob Chaz. He's much better than this one. Yeah, this is the Royal Rumble 99 setup arena. That was where The Rock and Mankind had their match, the I Quit match. And of course, that's where Mr. McMahon won the Royal Rumble, and I was pissed. But it was a good pay-per-view. It's like the first pay-per-view I watched where I would go to my friend's house every weekend. Not the very first pay-per-view I watched in wrestling. That was Survivor Series 94. But my friend Raven, Randall, a.k.a. Raven, he would his mom would order pay-per-views every month, and Royal Rumble 99 was the first one of those where I would watch every month. And that was pretty cool. All right. Oh, here it is. Oh, reverse Death Valley driver of the Undertaker. Now, that was cool, but I don't want you to win or anything. Come on, Undertaker, get up. You're from Death Valley, Undertaker. You should be able to withstand the Death Valley driver. No, don't lose like this. No, kick out. Jeez. All right, the fun's over. Get rid of Chaz. All right, they both did the back body drop simultaneously. Oh, another cool move. All right, Chaz has a few cool moves. Still, get out of there. Your little towel, tights, whatever you got on, look like Val Venus. With this Mankind smiley face. Get out of there, man. Jared Brisco ain't playing around. He's hanging in there just like Pat Patterson. Come on, Triple H. You gonna let Chaz beat you up like that? Chaz also has some sorry interest music. Jeez. That character is... I got nothing against the human being behind the character. It's just the character was so terrible. Oh, man. Have Headbanger Mosh get out of here and come back as Headbanger Mosh, and I'll be cool. Another cool thing about Mosh was him and Thrasher beat the crap out of ICP on an episode of Raw one time. That was cool. Undertaker and Triple H, of course, had their share of battles. WrestleMania 3 times. And when Undertaker became 20-0 at WrestleMania 28 by defeating Triple H in Hell in a Cell. Man, that's a freaking epic match. Undertaker, just throw him out. Or pin him. You gotta be kidding me. Yes, yes, thank you. What are you doing, Triple H, you idiot? Undertaker, you had a chance to eliminate Chaz. Man, I don't get this. The CPU is trolling me right now, and I'm not even playing. Oh, there you go. Triple H, leave him alone. Jeez. He tried to jump to the other side, and Triple H cut him off. How a ton is that? Ah, that's what you get. Come on, Jared Brisco. Pin him. Ah, jeez. Come on, Undertaker. Why are you teaming up with Chaz? No, don't. Oh, jeez. I was about to say, don't tell me Chaz eliminates the Undertaker. Wait a minute. Chaz, you idiot. What? Okay, which one is... Oh, wow. I'm surprised Jared Briscoe's getting up for that. And who got him? Who's the one that actually hit him? Okay, Briscoe's eliminated. Come on now. Get Chaz now. Come on. I did forget to mention, yeah, this is now a traditional Royal Rumble match. It's pinfall, submissions, and all that good stuff. Makes it more interesting. Yes. Jericho, who is in revenge, is now in WrestleMania 2000. He made his debut in August of 99, 3 months before this game came out, so he barely made the cut. That was awesome. Jericho's debut, one of the most memorable debuts ever in wrestling history. Oh, putting the Walls of Jericho. It's not the Lion Tamer like it was in Revenge. It's the Walls of Jericho. Oh, he makes Triple H tap out to the Walls of Jericho. And Chaz is still in there. Yes, Big Boss Man about to be inducted in the Hall of Fame. Come on, make Chaz serve hard time. Boss Man, he was involved in some funny storylines. One of them being the stupid Kennel from Hell match with Al Snow. And what was it? He cooked Al Snow's dog and had Al Snow eat it. Al Snow didn't even know he's eating his own dog at first. And then, what was it? He made fun of the storyline, kayfabe, Big Show's dad passed away. And then Boss Man is making fun of him, making fun of the whole situation. Show up at the funeral, drag the casket across the funeral, and Big Show's on top of the casket. No! So stupid, man. Then Big Show looks so sadistic and everything, but it was just stupid, though. Yes, thank you, Jericho. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Man, you really are here to save the WWF. You're here to save this video by getting rid of freaking Chaz. All right, Jeff Hardy now. Dang, look like Jeff, look like Kurt Cobain. All right, so Jeff Hardy, this is before, this is after the plaid clothing that they wore, him and Matt Hardy wore. This is right when Michael Hayes managed them and about transformed them. This is when the Hardy Boys is starting to get a little popular. Oh, Swanton Bomb. Man, Boss Man and Undertaker had that Hell in a Cell match at WrestleMania 15. And like the Undertaker hung Boss Man. Obviously, he wasn't really hung, but they put a noose around his neck. And I think Boss Man's going to get vengeance for that. And he just did. Yep, we got the final three right here. Yeah, so Undertaker hung Boss Man, but of course he didn't really hang him. But Venom 22 told me a friend of his asked him, "Did he die?" Unfortunately, Ray Trader did pass away, but not from being hung. He passed away years later, and again he'll be going to the Hall of Fame this year. Oh, shoot, I forgot. Just like in Revenge, they could probably pull you out of the ring. So you better watch out. Oh, Jericho wins. Come on, Jericho. Yeah, Jericho is so over in WWE. Oh, Boss Man doing some hard time here. Still wrestling with his sunglasses, though. Jericho cut him off. Aw, oh, come on, Undertaker. No, don't pull out Jericho. Jeez. All right, so that is down to Boss Man and Jeff Hardy. Or as Mike Adley would say, Jess Harvey. I want the Boss Man to win because he's going to the Hall of Fame. And yeah, so that's cool that that's going to happen. Wait a minute, but he might not win. Oh. Well, win, lose, or draw, he'll be in the Hall of Fame this weekend, and another part of me wants to cheer for Jeff Hardy, but I mean, Boss Man, watch him during my childhood. It'd be cool if he wins right here. Oh, nice reversal. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, Boss Man still kicks out. Oh, nice. Wait a minute. Oh, nice reversal. Oh. Wait a minute. Could this be it? No, it's not. Wait a minute. Oh, no. Boss Man catches him. Throws him off. Could this be it, too? No. Oh, Jeff Hardy counters that again. Wait a minute. Ah, jeez, come on. That's all right. He's still going to the Hall of Fame. Jeff Hardy wins. So, yeah, that is it for Road to WrestleMania, WWF WrestleMania 2000. Very fun wrestling game. You can create a character, create many characters, and like I said, Shawn Michaels and Mae Young. I think Mae Young is a hidden character. Not really sure, but I know Shawn Michaels is. So, yeah, this game was very, very fun. Better than Revenge, and Revenge is a real fun game. So this game is even more fun. So definitely check it out if you haven't. Definitely fun with 2 to 4 players and the Battle Royal. And so, yeah, lots of stuff to do in this game. Interesting songs, all that good stuff. Yeah, this game is definitely fun to play. So check it out if you haven't played it. And that is it. I am out of here. I got one more game to go, where you can take a guess what that game is. I'm Ron Moore. God bless. Take care.